This is Dexter. He is 5 years old, and he's a medium-sized dog, only weighs 38 pounds, yet he can jump my 6-foot fence, specifically the gate. So we decided that we were going to give this a try. The installation is step-by-step very easy. What I ended up doing was I kind of took a prying tool and I would dig just a thin line in the dirt, which was maybe an inch to an inch and a half, just enough so I could put dirt back over it. And when I got to my wooden fence, I would either drape it along the post or I'd weave it in and out of the planks. I have it coming into my window. So here's your unit. It will close like this. I have two wires and they are going through the window. How you're going to insert the wires. Right now it's telling me that it's not connected correctly. I'm just going to push these down and slide it in. Make sure that you've stripped a good piece off. So it'll read it easier. Okay. You're gonna go up all the way to 10 and then you're gonna turn it back. You're gonna hear that, you're gonna adjust it accordingly. And these are your ground terminals. Unplug the power source and I'm gonna flip it over. Right here is where your fuse is. Now they give you an extra fuse and in the instructions it shows that you can keep the extra fuse here. Let me open the bag. Now first of all, the fuse does not fit. It'll just fall right out. So you cannot keep your fuse where it tells you to. You do have the ability to mount this if you would like. And it comes with some anchors and screws so you can. So here's the collar, and of course it's adjustable. You have a little LED light here, and that's going to help you indicate which mode that it's on, as well as whether or not it is working. You have your contact points here. They do give you extra contact points. To work it, you're going to hold it down. And that's to indicate that it's on and it is connected with the box. Okay, if you can see this LED light here, I'm going to go through the modes with you. It blinked 5 times, meaning it is on the highest setting, and that is the high static correction. 1 is no static whatsoever, it's just a beep. 2 is low static correction. 3 is medium, and 4 is medium high. And depending on your dog and the energy level that they have, and persistence depends on which one that you will need to put. And it's a static buildup charge, like when you're wearing wool socks and you're shuffling them on the carpet and then you touch someone and you shock it, it's the same thing. I adjusted the collar so that way the contact points were underneath his neck, but it wasn't choking him, it wasn't hurting him, he was still comfortable.
Come here, Dex.
I had it on the second mode. He would get close, but the beeping freaked him out, and then he would back off, which was good, and I would walk him through different areas of the perimeter of the backyard, and so he would get close to it, and it would start beeping, and I would call him back to me and praise him.
And he was good with that. But
okay, come on.
When I went past the flags and opened the gate and went on the other side of the gate, he went and jumped the fence and he didn't yelp or anything. So then we tried on the third mode, and then we did the fourth and then the fifth. 2-3 seconds it takes him to get past it. He's willing to keep doing it. So it doesn't work with my dog. I think why it's not working with my dog is he has already realized that if he can get to a certain point, that it doesn't give him that static charge any longer. So if he can just endure that, and it works as advertised. It doesn't work exactly for my dog, but the product is still good. It's still doing exactly as it's supposed to, as it's advertised. Thank you very much for watching, and have a good day.